The following Saturday, the air show was held at Feilding. The air show of Top Dressing, with all aircraft, from Fletchers to AgCats to helicopters, you name it, it was all there. But before the actual air show went ahead, a briefing, as always.
List of it, the photocopier broke down before, so we painted any photocopies of it. So the tiger moth was going to start it, but we rang them up this morning and said don't try, because I think they'd still be trying to get here by tonight. So that's sort of a sequence of which the aeroplanes came into service in the industry. So we're just going to run through it like that. We're still waiting for Ray Patchett to turn up with the 180, but we've got the next three. And Robin Langslow, we're still waiting to see Robin today. Come in, Ray. This is, anybody who doesn't know, Ray Dennis. You must do if you're in this industry. You can do a bit of commentating today along with Janik Geelan. So we're scheduled there to start at 10 to 2 with Mike and the Beaver if he just taxis out and goes up past Dave's place and picks up a couple of tonne of line. And I think if everybody's going to do the actual egg displays, those aeroplanes that are spreading line, there's just the three of them, four of them here that'll be spreading line. If they just take off and just do a dumbbell turn and do, say, a couple of runs up the field, up and down the field, and then if you so wish, just do a short handling display, and then just round and land again. What is the grass like?
Right there,
is it? Is it?
Most
of you guys then will be using the seal, you know? Yeah, but they can taxi off the seal, no troubles.
Yeah.
And taxi across the grass.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
Beaver's not too good.
What's that?
The beaver's a bit something for the beaver.
Yeah, and then but the three 180 guys can sort of just get together and have a talk. The Hunter and Bill and Clyde's got BDE, Clyde Rowlands. So if you're right, I think if you just take off and just sort of do a go around on a wide circuit and just mind abreast, fly down the field like that. And if one of you wants to do a couple of steep turns or something, probably if you did that, Bill, do you want to do something like that?
But he's more skilled.
Okay,
well,
you two guys work it out.
So.
Yes, okay then. And then Ben's going to tow a glider off with the 300 Fletcher. And what'll that take you, 5, 6, 7 minutes?
Yes, and that's fair.
Yeah, the glider will do a couple of loops or something on the way down. And then John Stevenson, yeah, he's another one we're still looking for. He should be round about. He'll just fly the Agricola just up and down the paddock a couple of times. And the same Dave and the Pawnee, they won't be saying anything, of course. Robin Langslow in the 185. And then Bob in the Agwagon. Put in a little bit of line, same again as what Mike will do. Then the 400 Fletchers, Bob Monds will do a spraying display and then chain, sew some line. Jet Ranger is supposed to be coming over, then Andy in the Cresco, Dave in the Husky, myself in the AgCat, Keith in the Sikorsky, Ian Wakeling and Robinson. We'll finish off with the PD6 Cresco. The timetable will vary a little wee bit. I can't lecture you guys. You can all lecture me, no doubt. Fairly difficult conditions. It's pretty windy today, so just take it easy. No sense trying to impress the type of guys that are in the audience today. Don't want any problems. It would be the one quick way to ruin the weekend. So everybody just take it nice and easy. And I think that's about all. Any questions? Well, everybody's familiar with it. The wind's virtually straight down the runway today. The display line virtually across in front of the buildings. On the north side of it, the lines out here in front of Dave's hangar, and the gliding club headquarters here, and we're here. The aeroplane's there, if you just sort of keep north of that line. There's no minimum heights to anybody, just sort of more or less do what you do, what you want to do, as long as it's safe. Any questions?
I think for the three 180s, if we just sort of do a fly past, Robin Langlow will be current.
Yeah.
He should really do a handy display.
Yeah, okay then. Hallett,
with the chopper, I wanted to just show how the thing can handle maneuverability. Everyone looks at it and laughs and says, well, you know, how does it maneuver? Well, I think a lot of the guys would be interested to see that. So
yes.
I was wondering if I could do sort of a couple of prey runs across wind.
Yes.
Which would, of course, bring me toward the audience. But if I did it well out, beyond the display line, would that be acceptable?
No, that's okay. The only thing is a set of wires, you know, outside the airfield.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
The north side, running through a paddock through here, the model aeroplane headquarters. There's a windsock there.
Right.
That's the only obstructions. Yeah, if you come in like that, as long as you pull up your turn, and don't come over the guys. We haven't got approval to run this air show, but our contact is still aviation. As long as we're not charging on the gate, we don't have to have approval for it. Okay then. Any other?
Just basically, you've all got 5 minutes from takeoff to landing. So if you take 4 minutes from it, you know, if it gets a little bit behind. I don't think it will. You know, 5 minutes is ample for what you want to do.
Yeah.
So we try and keep everything on that 5 or 10 minutes. Mm. And you'll see that there is a 10 minute gap where we thought we might have a few more aeroplanes. The 180s, you've got 10 minutes, so you've got plenty of time. And there's no rush. Well, unless everyone wants to get back over to Palmerston North. But thanks very much for coming.
We just see Mike hasn't got a watch, so we'll run out with a flag. We flag when it's all over.
Warm up time's going to serve us up a bit too. Because warm up, you're making a noise whilst.
Oh, I know, we have to put up with that.
Yeah.
What would be your
honesty? That's part of the nuisance that you put up with if you select an operator without a turbine.
Yeah. Where's the bug?
Put on your honesty. Some of those guys are ready and it's all bullshit. Get a load of
life. Andy can be loaded where he is. Can you get the truck around to where the Cresco is at the moment?
Yeah.
So you can be loaded up. You can get loaded any time, Shane. And same with.
Yeah.
Like, what about Paul? You wouldn't want to start yours, would you? Shut it down, would you? The trouble is the guy's driving the loader wants to go away and play rugby.
I'll be able to do that personally.
Yeah, you can do that.
But just the
So you just taxi up 5 minutes early.
Yeah.
Or to Dave's hangar there, Shane put the
load
in.
Shut it down, no problem.
Oh yeah. You just sort of forget to count it.
Well, he's not here, Alan.
Okay then. I think that's all set. Thanks very much.
Well, first time, Bob.
Well, here we are at the Feilding airstrip on this 45th anniversary of Ag Pilots, 45th anniversary of Top Dressing New Zealand. With me I've got Clive Thorne in the studio here giving a commentary. What do you think of it so far, Clive?
Oh, very, very good, Mario. We have Mike now taking off in his Beaver, which is Langatiki Air Services, and he's now giving a display. Very blustery conditions on this day, but these pilots are all experienced and no doubt about that there was an excellent display. Let's watch the Beaver for a while.
Okay, Clive, and then we'll just sit back and watch the rest of the show, I think.
Okay.
Well, that was the end of the of Mike Cronin's Beaver display, Clive.
Yeah, very polished, Mario, very polished. Mike has spent a long time in the field, and everyone appreciates his display here today. Now we have the 180s taken to the air. Pilots Ray Patchett, Clyde Rowlands, Bill Saunderson, and Hunter McEwan. All experienced pilots from the ag world in the past. And these aircraft did a lot of top dressing over a number of years in New Zealand. And there's a lot of fellas on the ground today feeling very, very envy of these guys up in the air today.
I think so.
Yeah.
Okay, we've got the Fletcher here about to take off with a glider, Clive. But
yeah.
I think we had a little mishap.
Yes, yeah, it looked like the rope broke, but this can happen in these sort of things when you don't want them to. But it looks like they'll be hooking up again, and we'll shortly be away. The Fletcher is flown by Ben Stimpson, also an experienced top dressing pilot. And flying the glider is Terry Jones.
Yeah, and he put on quite a good display, as we'll see shortly, once he did get in the air.
Yes, very good. He's a high-performance glider, and he certainly can handle them. In these conditions of the day, it's not easy for him, as we'll see.
Righto. I will sit back and watch this display, if it gets underway and the rope doesn't break again.
Yeah, we'll be right. Here we go.
Well, looks like they're all hooked up again, Clive, and about to have another go at this thing.
Yes, it's one of those things I said before, it happens, but all ready to go now. I think we can sit back now, this time, and see them at their little fly. It's quite interesting with the glider behind the Fletcher. Don't very often see this.
Oh, well, it's a long, slow haul up there to about, what, 2,500 feet, Clive?
Yeah,
and looks like he's cut the rope now and he's on his own now going to do his display with the glider.
Yep. Very good to Terry Jones, a very experienced glider pilot, and I'm sending him with a nice little display here. Here we go.
I think, Clyde, that he done quite extremely well in the glider, doing his aerobatics, especially under the wind conditions he had.
Yes, Mario, but this is a very high-performing glider, and handling these conditions remarkably well, I think. Thank you.
Okay, he's coming in now, Clive, and doing the low pass at a quarter high rate of knots.
Yeah, very nice, isn't it? And the handle's going to do as well, doesn't it?
Excellent, absolutely excellent.
Very nice indeed. He's just better on the bound. Hi, it's one, Terry. You listening?
Good one. And here we've got John Stevenson in the Agricola, Clive. What do you think of this aircraft?
Very nice. Yeah, I have had the pleasure of flying that way in the top visiting days way back, and they proved themselves very well, but it wasn't to be that they carried on with the production of them. But however, we're lucky to see one of them left now, which is owned by John Stevenson and kept in very, very nice order.
Yeah, I heard somebody say to me that there's only one flying in the world or something. Would that be right, or is it just one in New Zealand flying?
No, that is right. The only one left in the world. And it's a credit to the Stevensons, which is Claude Stevenson and his son.
Well, we'll sit back and... John. And we'll sit back and here he goes for his display, and we'll sit back and see how it handles its paces.
Yeah.
Doing here, Clive? Looks like he's doing a bit of a slow fly past.
Yeah, it's flapped down and speed right back and just showing the controllability at very low speed. And John is now kicking the rudder a little bit there and showing that with the turbulence of front, stabilize out low speed.
Nice.
Comes John, John coming into land now and the Dricker, that's a nice little display. And you can see by the conditions, the aircraft's waffling around a bit, but no problem for John. He's on the ground, nice 3-pointer. Good on you, John. So what have we got here, Clive? Looks like now we've got the Pawnee flown by Dave Harding. Pawnee was a nice little aircraft used in top dressing in the earlier days, and of course, like everything else, load, weight, it was slowly, eventually retired, thankfully, from service, but here we are lucky enough to see one today flown by Dave Harding.
Are there still more flying in New Zealand, sort of commercially, sort of full-timish, or are they sort of being phased out a little bit?
Mostly phased out now. The odd company might have one or two, but literally nothing that much now with the Pawnee.
Okay, we'll just watch this display and see how it handles. Agwagon, flown by Bob Monds. The Agwagon is still actively an odd company flying in New Zealand. It was quite a popular aircraft for the pilots, and as you'll see, very maneuverable in the air.
Well, nice little landing from Bob there, Clive.
Yes, very nice. Very polished display.
This is a bit of a noisy little bugger here. What's this one here, Clive?
This is the 185, Cessna 185, flown by Robin
Langslow. Langslow.
Yes. Yes, and this one is fitted out with spade gear on, as you can see, and used now by Bob. By Robin, I beg your pardon.
Yeah.
Yes, I personally flew these aircraft, and quite a nice machine.
Looks like it's got quite a good bit of handling, handling manoeuvrability.
Yes, it is. Yes, it's very good that way, and quite a high, good rate of climb. We used to use around about up to 1,400 to 1,500 weight of them in the old days.
Okay, Clive, let's see how he handles this landing.
Oh, no problem.
No problem. Nice and short and straight to the point, eh?
Yep.
Here we've got Matt Dillon in the Hughes 300 about to give us a rotor wing demonstration on the old top dressing, flying a bucket there with a bit of super or something in it.
Yep, that's very nice. We'll see how he gets on with this one in these conditions.
comes in again for another load. I think it's coming in pretty quick. I think it might be only doing, say, a quarter bucket there for these conditions. Clive, what do you reckon?
I would say so, yes. There's no sense in putting the all-up weight in it now. Just showing us how quick the loads actually can be used in the aircraft. Really fast. And there we go again. That was a very quick turnaround, wasn't it?
Excellent, excellent. Good display, nice and clean, tidy.
Yep.
A couple of more Fletchers here. Fletchers 500s, 400s.
Yeah, the 400s are going now, and flown by Bob Monds and Shank Wareham.
Shane Wareham,
yes.
Shane Wareham.
Yes.
Let's see what sort of display these boys can put on. I'm not sure which is flying which aircraft, but I know Bob Monds is supposed to be flying one and Shane Wareham and the other, so I think they might be taken off either separately, but we can't see two in the air at the moment, but someone's coming in for a display anyway, so let's sit back and see how this guy handles his one. there's another Fletcher. Again, we're not sure which pilot is, either Bob Monds or Shane Wareham, but these guys are putting on a bit of a nice display here too, Clive.
Yes, he's coming now with the showing us with carrying a load of superphosphate, which in this case is lime, and doing a nice display also. And here we have the other one taxiing in, this is the spray machine.
This is the Cresco, Cresco, which is about to take off. Right. Yeah, I think it's getting ready to go up in the air.
Yes.
In the meantime, what do we have on? Oh, there he goes again, the the 400.
400 is still going.
Yep.
Very solid machine, Mario, those ones.
Yeah, I've had a chance to have a spin in one of these, sort of had a bit of a ride looking, over some areas we were spraying some time back.
I personally flew the 225 way back in the 50s, and I've come a long way since then.
Well, here we have a Cresco 700, I think it is, flown by Andy Stevenson.
Yes. I've come a long way when you look at this one now, haven't they, with the turbo motor 700, and a far more of a new machine, and upgraded from the old one. Let's see how it goes.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, that was nice quick landing, Clive.
It was, yes. I think I'll
probably put it in reverse thrust. Right, well, it's not often you see an aircraft doing that when it's on the ground.
This shows the advance in aviation, doesn't it?
Sure does. And here he goes again.
Yeah,
very short takeoff.
Is the Husky, and it's flown by Dave Warren. Very impressive display, very similar to the Agwagon. Upgraded model, I'd say.
Just touching the runway there before liftoff.
Yes. A very nice display by Dave Wareham and the Husky.
Well, it looks like we've got Hallett taxiing along to the end of the field for a demonstration in the AgCat.
Yes, Hallett, of course, as we know, is the organiser of the flying display here this afternoon, and he was he's having his turn now. His Agwagon with his TD6 motor, which is a turbo, I believe it's 600. It's a very nice display, as you've seen. He's a very experienced pilot in the ag world, and he won't be disappointed. So sit back and watch this.
well. What do you think of that display there, Clive?
Yeah, very nice handled by Hallett there. Old, once again, experienced pilot, showing us how it's done. A nice display, yes.
Well, this is certainly something different. Noel Sikorsky flying by Kev Turner from Master.
Yes, the old Sikorsky, a very nice old ship, isn't it? I can't exactly know what its payload is, I don't know, but it's in the tons. Okay, and Keith is a very experienced chopper pilot. Once again, we'll be watching a nice display, I'm sure.
Quite an ungainly looking aircraft, especially after you're seeing sort of watching jet rangers flying around in Hughes 500s, this old blunderbuss here, she doesn't look all that great, but it seems to handle quite well.
Yes, and it's the payload they carry now, and this, and certainly going off. And,
good way to climb there too, Clive?
Oh, yes. Yes. 2-3
Now we'll sit back and watch Keith put this machine through his paces.
Yes.
here we've got the Robinson coming in on the act as well here, flying by Ian Wakeling.
Yep, yep. Ian has been flying couple for many, many years, and once again a very experienced pilot. Coming in there now, so the little one goes. I don't know what his payload is, but could be in proportion of the aircraft.
So while Keith comes into land, he'll taxi along somewhere, and we should see the Robinson going through his paces any second now.
Yep. Oh, here he is now, coming in to the pitcher now. Neat little chopper, isn't it?
Yeah, excellent. Used mainly overseas for commuter flying, I think,
Yes.
But in New Zealand, they've sort of, like most helicopters, they've sort of gone a little bit more versatile, and they use them for all sorts of things, from live gear recovery to a little bit of lifting, and as you can see here, a bit of spraying.
Ah, yes, that's good, eh? And up a very tight display in lands there. That's nice.
Here we've got the final aircraft in the show. It's a Cresco 750, and this is flown by, I think, Paul Fenton.
Yeah, Paul Fenton. Fenton, yes. Slightly more power and a bit more versatile, I'd say. We'll sit back and watch this one for the final part of the show.
Very good flight. Yeah, it was quite nice. Very short though, very short landing.
Very smooth lines, Mario. Yeah.
Looks nice and swept and clean. It's off again in about 25 metres, 50
yes.
metres of runway.
Wouldn't be that long.
which is landed.
And what's in that display there, Clive?
Very nice, mate. Yeah, it's a lovely, clean aeroplane, as I said before, and a nice display. It just shows how over the years the advancements in the Fletcher, especially this machine, has developed over the last 35 years, and it wound up with a very nice machine. I'm sure the pilots love flying it. The crowd, very happy pilots of the past and present, enjoying the shows we put on this afternoon.
A good show too, Clive. Very well handled, especially under the conditions we had here. I think there's quite a blustery southwesterly wind coming through.
Oh yes, and the pilots did very well and given us a fine display. And walking around the aeroplanes on the ground now, Mario, if we look at a few.
Well, you've got the AgCat, which was flown by Hallett Griffin there,
right.
Put a nice display on.
Yeah.
Over in the back there, we have a few people looking at the Cresco, I think it is.
Cresco, yeah, they have a look at that one, that's right. Nice colour scheme, Mario.
Some would-be pilots there, maybe, or some ex-pilots.
Oh, most definitely. Some of them have flown before, some haven't, but who's ever there, they're enjoying it. But most of them have had their fair share in the air, I'd say.
Yeah, the old Fletcher there, I think it's a 300, if I'm not correct.
Yeah,
oh, here we are, Keith Turner, and there's Sikorsky.
Yep. I believe Keith enjoys flying this one.
Yeah, the big nose in the front is actually a cover for the radial, isn't it? It's a big radial inside that.
That's right.
That powers it.
That's right.
The same size radial as what's in the Beaver? I heard it was sort of the same engine, or was it?
I believe they were in the 450, but I believe that I might be quicker than that one.
Yeah. Still, it looked very good on the hand of this play, and quite stable, quite a stable machine.
Ah, yes. Yes, very nice. There's the old Agwagon from the past.
Yep.
And of course,
Agricola.
Agricola. Yes, this machine did its bit in the past, and here we are seeing it still in the field, even though not actively working now, but showing it's part of the past. Of course, there's my Cronin starting up at Beaver. I think probably taxied away for the dispersal. I personally flew these aircraft myself, Mario, and I enjoyed them. Here's the finish of the day, and the guys are now chatting about the show and talking about it, and certainly everyone's had an entertaining afternoon.
Cold, but entertaining.
Yes. I'm going to do the old identities there as we go past.
Oh, well, that was putting an end to the day. And it's on to the convention centre in Palmerston North for the night's activities, Clive.
Yes, that'll be a good show tonight.